Expert Ownership, Launching Faith-Filled Entrepreneurs into Greater Freedom and Success by David and Jason Benham. Dictated by David and Jason Benham, nationally acclaimed entrepreneurs, best-selling authors, SeeYaPreneurs. All right, we want to start by acknowledging a couple of key people because no one builds a business on their own. Though you may go faster alone, you'll only go further together. There are those that God places along your path to take you further than you ever imagined. Here are just a couple we'd like to thank. Alan Craven, our first real estate boss. Thanks for giving us a chance, for showing us the ropes, and then blessing us to go out on our own to do our own thing. Few business owners would have ever done something like that. Thanks. Tim Harrell, our college roomie and business partner. Thank you for being our best pal, for analyzing every business deal we've ever done, and for sticking with us whenever we jumped in. Without you, we'd still be mowing lawns today. David Troggett, our good buddy who encouraged us to impact more people by going digital. Thanks for walking with us as we parsed through mountains of content from our business journey. And thank you for showing us how to listen to the Holy Spirit's whisper. You helped us hear God in ways we'd never heard before. To our expert ownership core team, Larry, Trey, Sarah, we've heard it said that the best business owners surround themselves with people smarter and better than they are, which is certainly our case with you guys. Thanks. To all our former employees and franchisees, thank you for being patient with us. We had no clue what we were doing when we started, but you gave us grace and space to figure it out. Together with you, we built something special. Thank you. Introduction, dictated by David Benham, the better brother. Our business careers started shortly after we got out of professional baseball. Neither of us had any formal training whatsoever. No classes, no books, nothing. We were history majors at Liberty University, which was basically a degree to work toward while we waited for the major league draft, although we do love history. But we were armed with the principles and stories of the Bible, passed down to us by our pastor dad. He taught us to love the Bible and apply it to every area of our lives. The more we applied its principles to our work, the more we realized Scripture was a manual for business development. Upon launching into the business world, we learned that God's Word not only leads people to experience spiritual freedom, but freedom in every area of life, including the financial arena. And the more we focused on building our business upon Scripture, the more we discovered that the Bible contains firsthand secrets to success in the marketplace. In short, it taught us to be what we now call expert owners. With the Bible as our guide, we were able to develop a family of businesses that grew to multiple companies, both for-profit and non-profit, across the nation and in other parts of the world. And by the ripe old age of 33 years old, the two of us had transitioned from entrepreneurs to SeeYaPreneurs, as in, see ya, we're out of here. We had achieved financial freedom and no longer needed a business to sustain us at all. We could keep working if we wanted, but we didn't need to keep trudging that way. By God's grace, we had transcended the rat race, that's a Kiyosaki term, which is the ultimate financial goal of expert owners. Once you reach the level of SeeYaPreneur, all you really need to do is focus on impact for the rest of your life. You can start another business, build a nonprofit, serve in some other form of ministry, whatever you want, because now you're a SeeYaPreneur. And here's the best part. If we became SeeYaPreneurs, then you can too. Trust me. We're not the brightest bulbs in the box. As a matter of fact, Jason got an 820 on his SAT.
Speak for yourself.
But as long as finding this level of business success lines up with God's will for your life, nothing can hold you back from achieving it. If you combine a disciplined work ethic with a commitment to do business God's way, then just buckle up and watch what happens. But please hear us. None of this will amount to anything if you gain it all and miss the mark. The divine purpose God has for your life and the people He's entrusted to your care. We know how to build a business. We know how to make money. But we also know those things don't mean squat if you have to forfeit key relationships to make it happen. It means nothing to land a multi-million dollar deal if your daughter won't even talk to you. What does it matter if your company is worth $500 million when divorce papers are sitting on your desk? Who the heck cares that you own a private jet if you're walking away from God's will? This was the beauty of building our business on the principles of the Bible. It continually reminded us of what true success was. It wasn't defined in terms of money or accolades or opening new locations. It was defined by thriving relationships with God and people and impacting those relationships for His glory. You see, the question is not, how good is my business or how much money do I make? The question is, how deep are my relationships and how can I use my business to bless other people in them? The Bible is a book about relationships between God and the people He created. He blesses us so we can bless others. And if you can master relationships, you can excel in business, provided you implement some of the practical things that we discuss in this book. Every new business we open gets the same message. Our core is relationships, our foundation is the Bible, our goal is life, and that's in all caps, life. We want to breathe life into communities across the globe through the avenue of business based upon biblical principles. But here's a crucial fact. The Bible isn't just a guide for relationships at home and a manual for success at work. It's also a weapon for battle against the devil and his schemes. When you apply God's word to your life, you'll find that not only does success chase you down, so does trouble. We discovered this in the spring of 2014 after we signed a deal with HGTV to do a reality show on our business. Shortly after we started filming, and as commercials on our show began to run, liberal activists demanded the network pull the plug. They didn't like how vocal we were about faith in God and His design for marriage and the unborn. Long before HGTV came our way, we felt God wanted us to use our voices to speak about the moral evil taking place in our culture. Specifically, we knew God wanted us to do something about the plight of the unborn and say something about the redefinition of marriage. Plenty of other business owners pumped millions of dollars into Planned Parenthood and voiced their support for the redefinition of marriage, so we decided to do the same, just on the other side, the unpopular side. We admit that doing this was much easier before we experienced any success. Yet with a thriving national brand and a reality show on the line, the ballgame changed. If we spoke up, we better make sure to buckle up because it could cost us something. And cost us it did. The pressure from the activist groups was so extreme that a few months before our show was set to air, HGTV fired us. We found ourselves living out a great dichotomy. Applying the truths of the Bible to our work brought us promotion, but applying them to our walk brought us persecution. The same principles that got us hired got us fired. You may have heard that part of our story before. We shared in our first book, Whatever the Cost, but this book isn't about why we got fired. It's about why we got hired in the first place. It's our story of how God's truths applied to our work actually worked and put us in the position to have a reality show centered on the company we built. This book contains the guide that we created to help us build multiple businesses across several verticals to achieve financial freedom and independence long before reality TV came knocking on our door. You see, when HGTV fired us and the media smeared our names through the mud, it didn't affect our income one bit. Sure, some of our businesses took a little hit, but personally, we never missed a beat. By that time, we were financially free, and there was nothing anyone could say or do that was going to change that. Our income was not determined by people liking us. And as any entrepreneur will tell you, that's a wonderful place to be. It's the place where we want you to be. It's where you can be if you apply the steps we outline in these pages. So what is an expert owner anyway? At its core, an expert owner is someone who views God as the true owner of their business and themselves as stewards of it. Because of this, expert owners give God the final say over everything that they do. With God calling the shots, they view their business not just as a means to generate income, but as an engine for impact, a tool through which they can glorify God and bless people at the same time. The Expert Ownership Program is the 12-step process we developed to help you become an expert owner. It's built upon three pillars: a thriving business, financial freedom, and a life of impact. If you want these three things, this program is for you. We're going to show you exactly how we achieve them and how you can too. But be warned, we talk about God a lot. This book pulls no punches. We leave it all on the table. everything that has brought us success in the world.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.